Grey Lady Ale. Judging by the label, they might have called it Handsome Lady Ale. Yo! Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to the Beers
Gone Bad.
Huh?
It's where their beer feels like wine.
Wine?
Tonight we're doing Grey Lady Ale from Cisco Brewers, Nantucket. This was sent to us by our friend Katie LaFollette. She has recently relocated to Newport, Rhode Island, and she decided to bless us with some presents.
Thank you.
Let's get into it. Boom! This is a Belgian white wit beer, you said, right?
Yeah. They're right about one thing. I don't know if gray nails it, but cloudy.
Yeah, the wit definitely cloudy. Comes across as that really, like, murky. It comes across like one Bud Light, 10, like, Old Rasputin kind of color. This has got, like, a 2 on color, but, man, this thing is cloudy. I cannot see through it.
Yeah, not at all. You know what it reminds me of? And I've gone to this one a couple times, and I don't want this to seem like my go-to, but this is just who I am. It reminds me of when you put orange juice into booze, malt liquor, specifically.
Hey, you reference that a lot.
Yeah, it's a great drink, but I mean, that's what it looks
it
and
smells like to
like.
Me, that strawberry banana Kerns that you get at the grocery store. We're on Rate Beer.
Rate it.
Rate Beer gave it a 67. It says, the name Grey Lady comes from the nickname of the old foggy island for which it is brewed. The Sift Malty Mid-Palate has wicked good zesty hops.
Are they wicked good?
So, the Sift Malty Mill Palate has wicked good
basically,
zesty hips.
What you're going to get here is you're going to get a wicked awesome beer with wicked good hash. Ah, the crescent board. Kick ass.
Cheers to you, buddy.
Hey, cheers to you. I'm a little nervous. You know what I'm smelling, too? Fruit Loops.
It kind of does smell like Fruit
yeah,
Loops.
Yeah, it totally does. I love Fruit Loops.
I believe that this thing is a 4.5 ABV. And the cost is unknown. Cost unknown.
Do you ever go to a party?
The lady's kind of cool. Have you seen the front, dude? Yeah. I don't have to cut you off. I'm sorry. But it's a naked mermaid
That's cool.
A three-tail. She has a it looks like a maple leaf for a tail.
Yeah, it does. It does. It's a very rare tail style for mermaids, too. I studied mermaids in college.
That's a sexy woman.
I was
her
a
face.
Fictional marine biologist. She is not sexy. She's buff, though. Look at her arms.
It's like a caveman.
Like a gorilla with a tail.
Jeez. You think you'd find a prettier woman on your label?
Oh, it's the only mermaid we could afford. We were going to use Ariel, but contract negotiations. Gotta go with what you can get.
God, dude. It's not even like it's a picture. It's like a lithograph of one.
Yeah, it's like someone drew it. Can you draw a more attractive mermaid? Well, it's gonna cost you.
Well, I'm good from like beasts and centaurs.
I'm more of like a centaur, minotaur artist, but
whatever.
I'll dabble in the fish.
How do you feel about leaves for scales and tails?
I've always thought leaves made interesting tails. How do you feel about that? I don't know what to make of that. All right, cool. I'll just run with it. Looks like she's about to punch the bottle. Just hold it like this. Drink it! Yeah, drink the beer, right? It's a Boston style mermaid. Oh! It's this one. It's a beer. Oh!
This is from Nantucket, Massachusetts, by the way.
Which is also home to the great show Wings.
Oh god, dude. I love Wings.
Right?
Too bad it's not on anymore.
Yeah,
that was a great show.
It's a good show. There's not quality programming like Wings on anymore. Yeah.
As a Belgian wit beer, so this is gonna be your standard wit beer, something like, I'm assuming like Hoegaarden, Leff, with a Belgian yeast strain in there.
It
almost has a sour note to it.
You know what's really funny? Is I was trying to think of what I was going to say earlier, like 5 minutes ago, and I was like, God, I don't remember. And I took a sip, and it immediately came back to me. I was like, okay, that's it. You ever go to a party and someone made the guacamole, and they're like, yeah, you gotta put lime in guacamole. You gotta put lime juice in guacamole.
And they put lemon?
And they put, like, a whole bag of limes in there. They're like, all right, a little bit of cilantro, a little onions, and they're just like, yeah, and lime juice. And it's basically like, oh, wow, that's it's a citrusy anything
you want. So I'm right when I say it's sour.
Yeah, absolutely.
Do you think that's intentional?
I don't know. I feel like this is the kind of brewery that might just easily miss the mark, like drawing attractive mermaids making a tasty beer. fuck it, put it in the bottle. It's fine. It's abroad, right? Yeah, show some tit. You're fine. pull a hair back on one side. I don't care if it tastes like lemons. The only problem I have with this, I don't care that it tastes like lemons. I don't care that the mermaid's like a meme with long hair. But she's not fighting anything. And there's not enough leaves. Can you have a fighting leaves? No, I don't do fighting leaves. I can have her fighting a bottle. Yeah, have it like punch in a bottle. Like, hey, fucking drink it. Drink it.
This thing is sour, man. I don't know if that's intentional or not, but it's sour. I feel like it's got like a very slight sour tart, like a sweet tart or a shock tart to it.
What are you gonna rate this beer? Let's do it two ways.
I don't think it tastes like beer. That's the weirdest thing. Yeah, it tastes like fermented like kerns.
If you had to rate it as a beer, what would you rate it? If you had to rate it as a fruit, what would you rate it?
All right. If there were such thing as a shock tart fruit drink, it's okay.
Huh.
If it was a beer and I got this in a pitcher or a pint at a bar, I'd be kind of annoyed and maybe confused. Like maybe they by accident opened their Capri Sun and poured it into my drink. With some orange juice on it? I don't know. It's weird. And because of that, it gets a 3.5.
Yeah, I was going to give it a 4, but I think that's kind of generous.
Great lady. I enjoyed your logo. I mean, Jesus, we just talked about that thing for 5 minutes straight.
Yeah, I mean, there's one thing that you can't deny, and that's true artistic talent.
Whatever. Katie, thanks for sending it, though. Like,
yeah.
We always like trying new stuff. Please, like, I think you and I get more excited. I don't know about you. I get more excited when we try something funky because it's super fun to rip on it.
Yeah, it is really fun.
My beers are like, wow, that was
so it tastes really good.
That was great.
It's kind of fun when they're not good because you're like, well, I don't care. Yeah, it was good. It was a fun review. A beer in a bottle, it was.
Katie, get out there and find us some more funky ones. I would love to have them come over.
If you guys are from Nantucket Island and or Nantucket or Massachusetts or Boston, and you think that you guys have a beer that's going to be better than this one, let us know. Send it over. We'll pick it up. Whatever.
Yeah, that'd be great.
Just, hit us up. Facebook, Twitter, YouTube, Flickr.
The beer's gone bad. Pat Tujan.
Like wine's gone bad. I don't know. That's a question.
Are they fish vaginas?
That's a question for a marine biologist. Send that one to the Scripps Institute.